my channel. In case you're new here, my name is Lorena and I love to share my recipes with you. And if you've been here before, then hello again. Today we're going to make something really yummy and healthier than most things that I do on the vlog. So today we're going to do some turkey burgers. I'm going to teach you the way in which you can make them really nice and moist and interesting, because turkey tends to be a really plain flavor. I'm going to eat my burger in a bun, but you can by all means eat it on a plate with a piece of salad on the side. But I'm going to have it in a bun with some caramelized onions, which I've already told you how to make on the polenta video. I'm also going to have some avocado and some watercress, which I love because they're really peppery and will go great with the turkey. As always, if you want to see the recipe, then all you need to do is click on the link in the description box below, and that will take you to the blog where you will find lots more recipes. Also remember that if you like this video, you can always put thumbs up to it and subscribe to my channel if you haven't done it already. I'm now going to make these turkey burgers, so if you want to see how it's done, then keep on watching this video. Okay, so the first thing that we need to do is our mix for the turkey burger. So the reason why we like beef burgers so much is because they have fat in them, and that makes them really nice and juicy. Also the fact that we can cook them to medium, which means that there's still juices inside from the meat. However, these we have to cook through, so the only way in which you can make them juicy is to add some fat into it, because turkey doesn't have, and this is turkey breast, so it doesn't have fat at all. So we're going to replace that with some olive oil, which of course is much healthier than animal fat. I also have here some salt, pepper and paprika, which will give it a really nice and smoky flavor. You can also add in oregano, rosemary, any herb that you like, but at this point, because I'm eating it with the watercress, I don't want any herbs fighting with that flavor. And I'm also going to add some Dijon mustard, which I think is really nice and will also go well with the turkey. Shape them, so I'm going to divide it in four, which is the amount of burgers that I want from here. You could also divide these by weighing out the amount of mix that we have, and then divide it by four, and then you get your perfectly exact burgers, but for me this is enough. Today I'm just cooking one of these, so I want to teach you how to store them in case you want to do that. You're going to need some baking paper, and you're going to cut it and put it first at the base of your container. Then you put one of these inside, then another piece of baking paper, then another one on top, and so on. And so this is the chosen one, the one that I am eating in about 10 minutes. Okay, so while my oil heats up, I'm going to toast my bread. And for me, any sandwich, whether it's a burger, a grilled cheese, or anything, it has to be toasted on the inside and on the up. So what I'm going to do is just cut it in half and put it inside that small oven that I have over there, and let it toast on the inside and on the outside. I have my pan here on medium heat, and that's really important because if I have it hotter than that, and it will burn on the outside before it can cook all the way through, and that's something that can't happen with turkey nor chicken nor pork, because then you get the risk of getting salmonella. So you want it at medium heat so that it doesn't burn and that it cooks through, and you don't want it too light because then it will take ages and it won't go golden. So I have here a bit of olive oil and I'm just going to fry it. When we see that it's turned white about halfway through, we're going to flip it. Amazing, now it's ready, nice and golden. I and it's going to rest for about 10 minutes before we plate it. And this is really important so that when you bite into it, the juices don't come all the way out, but they stay inside the burger for you to enjoy. On the base here, I'm going to put some avocado. On the lid here, I'm going to put a bit of Dijon mustard. But of course, you can use whatever sauces you like. After this, I'm going to put my turkey burger. Then some caramelized onions. These are still warm, by the way, because I just made them. The watercress, but I'm not going to put it just like this. I'm going to season it with a bit of salt, olive oil, and a bit of lime juice. And there you have it, a beautiful and delicious turkey burger. Wait a second, I was about to take the pictures of these and then I saw that I actually used the base, the top at the base of this. So I'm going to try and put it back onto here. Oh, Lorena. Now we're talking. Turkey burger recipe. I really hope you liked it. It was so good. If you did like it, don't forget to put thumbs up to this video. It makes me really, really happy. Please, if you make this recipe or any other recipe from the vlog, don't forget to send me pictures or tag me on them because I really love to see what you cook. Also, if there's anything that you'd like me to teach you how to make, whether it's savory or sweet, you can leave a comment below. I'm posting videos every Thursday and Sunday, so if you don't want to miss any of them, then I recommend that you subscribe to my channel. It's free and only one click away. You can also follow me on Instagram, Pinterest, and Facebook as Cravings Journal. Thank you so much for watching this video and see you next time.